Alright. What's to here?
You must gather your party before venturing forth.
Oh. Huh. This is that place. We can come out here. This goes out to the docks. Okay.
Why me?
I had no idea this was even here.
Alright.
Alright, so let's go talk to him and...
Hey, sexy. Do you want to take a look at me, Diddy?
Me, Diddy. Alright, so saving.
I need a swig of some strong dwarven ale.
Of course, I'll be worthy of this honor. You will for sure. Oh yes, you will. Come to the southeastern district when you are ready, brother. This key opens the doors of the last warehouse to the south there. Meet us inside. Okay, he took a potion. I don't know what that's about. But if we talk to him again, then he says we've made an enemy, so I don't know if that's working right. So, there's the warehouse key. This key opens the warehouse in the southern district of the city. The Serpents of the Abathur have their hideout there. So we can, like, go there and just, like, kill them. Or try to, anyway. So we can go out this way. This way we might avoid the guards.
All right.
I need a swig of some
strong. Hello there, young'un.
Did you hear that? There's an orc attack at a house near the Elf Song with an injured girl in the middle of the city. Can you imagine that? Orc attacks in Baldur's Gate. Oh. There's a rumor that a house near the Elf Song Tavern was attacked by orcs and the inhabitants need help. Oh boy. Where are we? Oh, the Blushing Mermaid? Oh. I thought we were by the docks. I thought that was that.
Why?
I need a swig of some strong dwarven ale.
Who's this? Ivan. Aye, would you like to pay a penny for tale of murder and deceit? 10 gold it be, and worth each one. All kinds of people coming up on us. Tiny here says, this tale must be dark indeed, if she asks for a reward. The foul tales aren't enough, and despair in this land, and are told freely to every passerby who would listen. But this tale will be something special. A dark price for a dark tale, but I'll pay and hear it told. It's only 10 gold. Heh, Scar it was, second in command of that noble flaming fist, and on a night dark street it happened. The rain, 'twas spattering against the window's glassy panes, and soaking up through me boot wraps, giving me the chill. A cunning cutthroat rushed on by him and cut the straps of his travel purse with a blood-sharp knife before turning down the alleyway. Aye, good man Scar, he chased the culprit there into the dark as I came stumbling through the puddles to his aid. But that petty cut purse, he weren't the rugged waif that he appeared to be. Nay, he was a silver-haired changeling, he were. And with his dagger claws, he gored the good man through the eyes. Then he slit his neck so vicious just to leave him bleeding in the rain. My proffered aid, you asked? Aye, 'twas... My preferred aid? Aye, 'twas as quickly withdrawn and rashly granted, and I hid there in the shadows as the mirror fiend assumed new form to saunter bloody-handed into the darkling night. My aid comes in that I'm here to tell the truth of the good man's passing to any listener that can spare the coin. 'Tis enough, I figure, And I doubt he'd disagree. These... They killed Scar. Oh, that's horrible. The mirror fiend you speak of is known as a doppelganger. I have encountered more than one of late, all in the hire of the Iron Temple. Do you know of any reason why the throne would want Scar dead? The Iron Throne, is it? Well, this lies outside me simple telling, but it may enrich it yet. Duke Elten lies sick within the compound of the Flaming Fist. So good man Scar had filled the former's office as their leader. Angelo, a link below the good man in the chain, had the most to gain by the killing, and it's he who I'd suspected. But the Iron Throne, I couldn't say. If you thinks there be some truth to it, you would investigate either the compound of the Fist or the Tower of the Throne, for therein would lie your answers. Journal update. Scar's death. I have listened to the tale of Ivan, sole witness to Scar's death, save his killer. Judging by Ivan's telling, Scar was lured to his horrific death by yet another doppelganger, no doubt in the hire of the Iron Throne, though Ivan pointed out that Angelo had much to gain from his death as well. Scar's passing was mercifully brief, at least, though more for reasons of stealth than of compassion. Compassion? I have seen so many of these foul mirror-kin of late, but I pray I never become accustomed to their cursed shifting faces. That's a sad tale indeed.
Sure.
Alright, so... A house near the Elf Song Tavern. We need to go to the Elf Song Tavern anyway to, go meet Shiloh Chen. That's in East Baldur's Gate. So I guess, yeah, the next one down. Just making sure it's not here, no.
Sure.
No time to chit-chat.
Herschel says, hello, hello. I don't suppose you'd be interested in a few trinkets? A coin or two for my finely crafted wares? Eh, I thought not. The iron shortage wanes, but even so, the customers do not come back quite yet. Who can blame them, though? They're afraid because they see that the merchants are still without wares. Who believes that a shortage has ended when they still cannot hold a new blade in their hands? I blame the Iron Throne, I do. And the others do as well. I'm not surprised. Their role in the iron shortage was pure villainy. Excuse me? Where have you heard such tales? As far as any are concerned in this city, the Iron Throne is a respectable, mercantile group. Such talk as yours without proof will get you nowhere, I am sure. But then what did you mean? I was talking about the Iron Throne's actions since Saravak has assumed control of it. He is disinterested and seems likely to sacrifice it to fund the rearming of Baldur's Gate, and thus his bid to become a Grand Duke. It is the Iron Throne's instability which has prolonged the strife in the city, and that is why other merchants blame them. They were major importers, and without their help it would take much longer to reassure people that all is well. It makes no business sense that they should do this, and I think there is something very wrong at their headquarters. Yeah, a lot more than you know. But that's fine. There's the Elf Song Tavern, if we can get there without being attacked.
All right.
By the Flaming Fist. That would be great. And the house nearby. Guessing it's... Well, that's a weapon shop. I guess I think it's one of these or these. Because the rest are shops. Yeah, that's... You can't even go in there. What's this? Make sure it's not in here. There's a girl.
Sure.
You shouldn't go places unless you're invited. Sorry, we're looking for... Ogres, I think? It's...
Sure.
Not me. It's not near Elfsong Tavern, but I figured since we're here... Making sure I don't have to.
Why me?
I don't know when I have to double back. Shop of Silence. Little Song Tavern here. So unless it's in the back of it.
I serve the flaming fist.
Hail! Halt and hold! You stand accused of murder most foul. You will lay down your arms and come with us, or by order of Angelo Dasan, you will be killed where you stand. Such is his order, and I cannot alter it. It is your choice. This probably means they'll fight us. Giving them money has never worked before. I have no wish to fight you. I am no murderer, and I welcome the chance to prove it. A wise decision. You will have a fair chance to defend yourself, regardless of how convinced of your guilt Angelo is. This way. So much for helping with the ogres in the house. Hello? Commander Angelo Dosan, these are the ones wanted by the murder of the Iron Throne leaders.
So, these are the infamous murderers, finally brought to justice.
I am Angelo, commander of the Flaming Fist. I will be your judge, jury, and executioner. Please pardon the cliché. But that doesn't seem very fair. Hey, back off, Imwin says. We did nothing wrong. Diner here says, if I weren't in the position that their claim is thine, I would not be quick to accuse innocence. Oh wow, this ugly and smelly pretender, lobotomized gibbling would make a better leader than you. We'll pay you more if you let us go. Laugh now when your arms and legs are severed and you're lying on the ground crying like a little baby, and then we'll see what's the last laugh. I don't think much of these choices. We could, like, savagely insult him. Mention Saravak and attempt to bribe him. Threaten him with, amputations, or just, oh no, I think this would be Imowyn's choice. That seems like a bad choice. That seems like a bad choice. I don't think this would work. I don't think any of these will work. Hey, come on now. We all know that you're in the employ of Saravak. We'll pay you more if you let us go. Addressing the greed in my soul, an admirable attempt, but one destined to fail. I am not stupid enough to cross one such as Saravak. I reserve that stupidity all to you. Now that we are done with all these pleasantries, I will make my decision. I had thought hard and long on what sentence I should give if you should be delivered into my hands. The choice is an obvious one. For the charges of murder, theft, arson, rape... Where are you getting this from? And many other assorted crimes, I declare that each of you shall be taken to the bazaar, where you should be hung by the neck until you are dead. What? The end? Oh, we're all in cells. Angelo is sentenced us to die by hanging. A foul of the law. For some reason, Duke Eltan is no longer the commander of the Flaming Fist. A man named Angelo now claims that position. I have surrendered myself to the Flaming Fist and must go before Angelo Dosan for judgment. I doubt I shall be treated fairly by this Angelo. Your doubts are well-founded. But I had little choice. If I were to fight the Flaming Fist, I would surely be known as a murderer of guards. They are only following the orders of their new commander and are innocent of any wrongdoing, regardless of their attacks on me. If I am ever faced with the same unfortunate choice in the future, I had best entangle the guards somehow and make my escape without harming them. That's an idea, actually. The fates would not look kindly on my killing innocents, regardless of their intent. And then... a house near the Elf Song Tavern. The cell door appears to have been tampered with. Interesting.
Sure.
Can I open other cell doors?
Such menial tasks.
Sounds like someone's going through treasure.
As directed.
Such menial tasks.
This one's open too. Who's Neb?
Useful gadgets I have. Yes, I do.
Hey, you. I wonder how you got out of your cell. Did someone leave it open? Or perhaps you managed to pinch my key? Oh, no, you haven't. So are you the group that's wanted for murder on 3 different counts? Don't try to deny it. I know it's you. Well, my name's Neb. Neb, do you know what's been going on in the city lately? Oh, yeah, lots of stuff. You know about Duke Elton, don't you? He's been diseased. Diseased. That's why Angelo's in charge now. It would have been Scar, but he went out and got assassinated. Heh. Yeah, the city's gone downhill over the last week. Too bad, heh. Once Angelo locked me up, I learned from a criminal called Neb that Duke Elton is sick and Scar has died. We already knew about Scar.
Fine.
You're getting impatient in here, are you? If I could help him get out. Oh, we can't open that, can we? Figured he would help us get out. I mean... is there some kind of lever that we're looking for? I've got a way out of here, you know. Heh, hidden it well, haven't I? Search all you want, and you won't find it, heh. Heh, good thing old Nem decided to mix a little bit of illusion craft with his thievery, eh? Sure, sure. I'll tell you what. Murderer to murderer now. Monster to monster. Are you wanting out? Please, we'll do whatever it takes. It's very important that we get out of here. Heh, sure, sure, everyone's wanting out, but does the world really want us out? Maybe it's safer if you all just stay in here. Heh, monster to monster now, murderer to murderer. How many little children passed away at old Neb's hands? Not one, not two, neither 4 nor 7, nor 12 nor 20, but the next one in the sequence. Ah, riddle. Okay, 1, 2, 4, 7. Okay. I get 1, 2, 4, and then you lost me at 7. 12, 20. Okay, increase by 1. Increase by 2. Increase by 3. Okay, but then increase by 5. 8. Thirty-eight children. 26. Oh, which one is it? 1, 2, 4, 7, 12, 5, 6, 7, 12. So we skipped 4 here. We went from 3 to 5, and then to 6. So 27 is my guess. 7 more. Except we don't have a choice for that. Oh, wait, that's 8 away. Okay, never mind. 3, 4, nor 7. So 3, 5, 8. Really just educated guess here, kind of. 1, 2, 4, 7, 12, 20. Funny, these are the same. You killed 38 children, Neb. How could you? You killed 38 children, Neb. And you're no more soul burn in each of the 9 hells. 26, 18, 41, 33, 76, 30. I'm guessing 30. I don't know. You killed 30 children, Neb. Do their voices not haunt you in your sleep? 33! The entire world should know that Neb murdered 33 children in the dead of night, and then you speak of it so disdainfully, too, as if it were beneath you. How many did you kill, then? 34? So you still want to get out, do you? Yes, I do hold the power in this situation, don't I? You can love me, you can hate me, it doesn't matter. You still must do as I wish. Quick now, a riddle for my captive audience. If you look at me, we look at each other, you with eyes and me with yours. If you speak to me, I only mime your words, for while I wear your lips, I have no voice. What am I, foolish ones? What am I? Doppelganger. Okay, if you look at me, we look at each other. You with eyes. A mirror? A mirror. A mirror, yes. Like you to me, or me to you. We are the same. We are siblings separated by a thin and fragile pane of silvered glass. Come, let me show you my tunnel, that we may make good our escape, my twin. A killer by the name of Neb helped us break out of the Flaming Fist prison. That's a done quest. So where are we now? By the Flaming Fist castle. That's right, because we were in there. In their prisons. Let's try our best to get out of here.
You need a new tailor. Your clothes are absolutely dreadful.
Lady, we're being hunted down by the Flaming Fist. I don't give a crap about clothes. He's just gonna attack us now. Kaela says, such insolence. His popularity may be soaring, but I'll not cast a vote for a lout such as he. The nerve of the man. That's the truth, but what is your trouble, my lady? If it is any of your concern, I'm simply furious at that Saravak man. I did not raise a fortune in this city by letting such as he stroll off with my assets. I have had dealings with the Iron Throne Mercantile Group for some time now, and though I did not approve of some of their other ventures, they were at least honorable business people in their contracts with me. Now that Saravak leads them, he has all but declared my previous deals null and void. You'll get no sympathy from me if you lost gold dealing with a group like the Iron Throne. If we were not ready incensed at Saravak, I would stop the Terra Strip off of you too. As it is, I must speak with the Grand Dukes about Saravak's conduct. Imagine, he secures himself as leader of the Iron Throne, but then all but destroys its mercantile credibility by practically sacking it. He may be bolstering the city with its assets, but it is still unprofessional. Something strange is going on at that Iron Throne building. I tell you, I know that their previous leadership was killed, but those members remaining would never let such treatment come to pass. Not willingly, anyway. The rise of Saravak. After gaining control of the Iron Throne, Saravak has begun to exploit its resources to the fullest. Even with their former leaders dead, the remaining members cannot stand such wanton looting for long. What does Saravak have in mind? Oh no, but let's get the hell out of here.
This group shows promise exceptional.
We can't kill this guy. Webbing him is a good idea. But let's just go. Can I get out of the map from here? Yes. We need to head to East Baldur's Gate. Elfsong Tavern.
Why me?
You gotta find out who's having trouble with orcs. Go in there. Could be there. I'll try these. So let's duck in here. What is this? Oh, it's a general store. It's not a house. This is Ken. Anyone have trouble in here?
Sure.
What do you want? Please talk to my husband. What do you want? I have heard that you have encountered problems with orcs. Do you need any help? By the nine hells, would that ever stop? Forgive my harsh tone, but the situation really starts to irritate me. To answer your question, no, we do not have, nor have we ever had, problems with half-orcs or any other monsters attacking the house, robbing my daughter, or any other similar things you may have heard. It is simply my son-in-law, who is of orcish descent, celebrating his wedding with my daughter. They are on their honeymoon now, fortunately. Don't get me wrong, I do appreciate your efforts and your will to help, but I'm clueless as to what I should do to stop these wannabe adventurers stomping into my house, thinking they can earn a sack of gold. You haven't been the first who's come here. You're talking about Ogoth, aren't you? I met him. He was quite unsure as to whether he would be welcome here. Ah, well, we were taken aback by his appearance at first, that is true, but he's a really good lad. Better manners than some of the local boys, that's for sure. I'm sure I'll get used to the thought about grandchildren with green skin and brow ridges someday. Journal updated. The rumor about orc attacks at a house in Baldur's Gate was exactly that, a rumor. It was just poor half-orc Ogoth, whose appearance was causing talk to spread. It's always the same with rumors. Alright, let's head to Elfsong Tavern.
Alright,
forget who I was supposed to talk to. Shiloh Chen. Should be in here, I think.
Sure.
Husam. Here he is. The Hawks tell me that you cleared away the Ogre Magi all by yourselves. I am impressed with your valor. Here, let me give you these fine gloves as a token of my appreciation. They are so supple that you can feel even the downiest feather as it brushes against your palm. Having defeated the Ogre Magi in the Wood of Sharp Teeth, Shiloh Chen has rewarded us handsomely. Alright. So this looks like a lot, but Sturlock's Tower. That's Baldurand's final voyage. I think that has to do with the reclusive scholar. Cordier, we're not doing. Durlag's Tower, we've already done this. Oh, right, we have to go to that warehouse. What is it? Durlag's Tower again? That's, I don't know. Yeah, it's that. Durlag's Tower. Serpents of Abathur. And this gnome. So we need to go to that warehouse. That guy's appearing and disappearing. Anyway, that'll be next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. Oh, we got bracers. Hold on 1 second. Huh. Gloves of pickpocketing. A few years back, Fong Mu, a famous cutpurse known in both Baldur's Gate and Ethkatla, was found dead on the road between the gate and Baragost. Seems he'd stolen an artifact from a powerful mage and tried escaping, with little success. His possessions went to a nephew, who took up the same trade as his uncle and became especially good at pickpocketing. Whether these gloves were magical before falling into Fong's hands, or if they are somehow imbued with the master's essence, is not known. Pickpockets plus 20%. Alright, cool. So she's already wearing Dale's Protector. Thaco plus 2 with missile weapons. Pretty valuable. I'll have her hold on to them in case we need to pick more pockets. I guess we'll head to that warehouse next. Thanks so much for watching, guys.
You bunch of chumps! What the hell do you think you was doing?
That guy's practicing invisibility and failing. See you next time, guys. Thanks for watching, and always seek adventure.